Attorney General Gary King came in last place during the Democratic pre-primary convention, but that's not stopping him from trying to become New Mexico's next governor. KOAT Action 7 News reporter Ana Velasquez spoke with our political analyst Brian Sandaroff about what this all means.
He's a one-term governor.
The finish at this weekend's Democratic pre-primary nominating convention for the governor's race took many by surprise.
The most well-known of the Democratic nominees for governor, Gary King, actually took last place. So that was not good news for him.
Attorney General and four others are all vying for the Democratic nod in June. The candidate who came out on top over the weekend was two-term state senator Howie Morales.
When you win the pre-primary nominating convention, it demonstrates that you have some grassroots support, some momentum, and it gives you a leg up for the Democratic primary.
King previously collected more than 10,000 signatures from registered Democratic voters, doubled the required amount, so his name will be on the ballot. In a statement to his supporters, he said, quote, "This is the kind of grassroots support it's going to take to defeat Susana Martinez. I am humbled by your support and this expression of confidence in me. I will not let you down." Sandaroff says King can still win the nomination because the primaries have a larger audience, but considering he's gotten more name recognition than anyone else on the ballot, he should ask himself why he did not do better among the delegates. Ana Velasquez, KOAT Action 7 News.
We'll find out how Gary King and the rest of the field do when New Mexicans vote in the primaries June 3rd.